time to deploy a secret weapon. Trunk cam is specially designed to film tigers in high definition while on the move. It's carried by what must be the ultimate all-terrain camera vehicle, an elephant. These eco-friendly 4x4s can take trunk cam wherever a tiger goes, and it can start filming the moment the alarm calls of prey animals give away the tiger's location. The human camera crew film from another elephant and adjust trunk cam using remote control. The elephants give us extraordinary access to the tigers. They are, after all, natural inhabitants of the forest, so the tigers aren't at all fazed by them. These innovative filming techniques have made it possible, over a period of 3 years, to capture the most intimate portrait of tigers ever seen. They gave us astounding insights into the tiger's private world and captured behaviour never witnessed before. Our story begins with a tantalising glimpse of something very special, a cub just 10 days old. Wild cubs as young as this have never been filmed before. For their first 6 weeks, most cubs usually hide away in their dens, hardly glimpsing daylight. These are unusually adventurous. They seem totally unaware of the dangers. Although their eyes are just opening, they won't see clearly for another 6 weeks. They're the mother's first litter, and they're going to be quite a test for her. The tigress must pick them up by the scruff of the neck. It's a delicate operation. A little too much pressure, and she'll hurt her cub. She can bite with a force of 1,000 pounds, but this requires the gentlest touch. Tigers usually have 2 or 3 cubs. 4 are quite a handful, and these already seem more challenging than most. The ratio between the sexes among newborns is usually equal. True to form, 2 of these cubs are male and 2 are female. It would be rare indeed for all 4 of them to reach maturity. Many dangers lie ahead. At this size, they make a snack for even the smallest predator. Their mother must make sure that everyone is accounted for. With 2 back in the den and 1 on its way, there's only 1 straggler left to worry about. The cub's contact cry makes sure he's not forgotten. As long as the cubs call, their mother is compelled to keep retrieving them, but this would try any mother's patience. A young cub's life is very precarious. Had the mother been away hunting at a moment like this, the outcome could have been very different. She's clearly going to be a devoted mother, but she still has a lot to learn. This is not the way to do it.